In this table, we see more about what we discussed in the first table. So it is Chok Tal. This is the law of Tal. Tal is a man who initiated this law, which enables the Shiva boys to learn, to study, and to be released from the army, to study the Torah, day and night. And yesterday, the High Court, the Bagatz, which they called, decided to annul it. No more this law, which definitely will cause a lot of trouble, that children, Yeshiva boys, will have to go to the army, so no doubt that it will cause a lot of problems. But we have here the best meeting of the Torah, of this bitul, the annulment of the law of Tal. So we saw in the first table really what the law of Tal is, but here we'll add some more things to see it clearer. So here you have, as we said before, Chok Tal, which is really Mishpatim Tzadikim Kechol HaTorah, these laws which enable people to learn Torah, as we saw. We mentioned in the other table that this is really which is a right for Israel to exist, as this was the purpose of creation, the Torah Bereshit, Bara Elohim, as our Rebbe Sela Bereshit for the Torah and for Israel, which is called Reshit, who are studying and keeping Torah. Now we see clearly that this law of Tal, which enables people to learn Torah, and studying the Torah is the most important thing for Israel to live and to be in the land. So here he clearly written, Leman, the reason is, Tichyun, that he will live, and Tov Lachem will be good to you, Varachtem will be long life, long days in your land, and condition, Zot HaMitzvah, החוקים המשפטים, אשר סיבה השם אליכם, ללמד אתכם. It means, these are the mitzvah, the חוקים, and the judgments that God commanded us to teach. And this is what the yeshivas are doing, studying, learning the nights, definitely. Then, you have here, as we mentioned, what happened when they annul this law, when they want the boys to serve in the army, not to study Torah. And one should know, like we have in the army, people who are working in the radio, Galat Zal, people who are doing other things which have nothing to do with fighting. So no doubt that these people also are serving. No doubt that people who are studying, learning Torah, they are nice, are really saving Israel. This is the sixth war clearly showed it, that yeshivas were studying there 24 hours a day, so miracles will happen because Israel lives on miracles, not on weapons, and in time that Iran, Chas v'Shalom, will have its atom, whatever they have in their missiles, and which they can do, shoot Chas v'Shalom in Israel, so definitely these many soldiers will help us, will not help anything, because only we have to pray and to say Tehillim that the worms will not fall, Chas v'Shalom, people, like it's happened with the scars and the grass, Baruch Hashem, that many of them, thousands, did not cause few cases of killing. So no doubt it's miracles, everyone agree. Like in the time, the scars in the Gulf War. So no doubt that we are living on miracles, which God keeps, that only the truth of keeping the Torah. This is what God says clearly here. If you want to live, to have good life and long life, is only if you fulfill all the Torah and the mitzvot. As he said, desecrating Shabbat caused the temple to be destroyed and the Jews to chase out from their land. And definitely not learning Torah, as Amalek came to attack Israel in the desert when they were losing studying Torah. The Gemara says, Refidim was the place, Rafu Yadim. Refidim was the first place that Israel gave back, by the way. Now, this is what we see, Charon Af, we say the anger of God, Iyum and a threat from Iran. Amazing, every six letter coming together with a threat, with anger, on the same place that you have annulment of the Chok Tal, which is best meeting, as we said, and exactly this place appearing this. So no doubt, as we said, that it is only doing repentance, doing tshuva, studying Torah, keeping yeshiva boys, learning as many as we can, and only this is the only way, in fact, to get long life in Israel, to have really peace and quiet and not danger from Iran, which is all the time doing everything and threatening to wipe out, Chas v'Shalom, Israel. So let us really understand from this table, which is part of the Torah, the Bible code, as we said, this is a part of Kabbalah, this is really the most important thing, right? And this is what is written there, exactly, Yishamer lecha, guard yourself, Shmor nafshecha meod, keep your soul, pen tishkach, when chas v'shem you will forget, et hadvarim asher ona will forget, that what you see in your eyes, in Sinai, Revelation, the Torah, which we got in Sinai, chas v'shem not to forget, because if forgetting it, chas v'shem will bring run, as the Gemara says, if Jews will not do tshuva willingly, so a leader, a cruel one like Aman in Persia will come and will endanger and threaten the existence of Israel. So let us do tshuva, and only by this we'll be safe in our land.